Good morning, boys and girls. Today is Wednesday, April 1st. It's a brand new month. It's also April Fool's Day, so you're allowed to tell your mom and dad as many funny jokes as you know. Okay, I hope you got a chance to read this story. I linked the class website, which I read the story aloud. Unfortunately, on class stories, I can only do one video post, so I had to use our website so that I could read this story to you. This is a really great one. Boys and girls, your assignment for today, for your family challenge, is to draw viruses and bacteria and germs and how you think they look. It would be so awesome if we had a microscope and we could see them magnified, but we don't. And so instead, I want you to use the books that you read this week, and I want you to draw what germs look like. Okay, so on this page, there's many examples. Viruses and bacteria, they all look different. Some are really long and curly, some have tails, some are spiky, and so it'll be fun to draw what you think a germ would look like under a microscope. And they're very colorful too, and at least in the stories we read. So have fun with that. Do that outside on your sidewalk using sidewalk chalk. All right, your ELE assignment today is to click the link to the Reading Rainbow video that I want you to read or listen to today. It's a read aloud. And when you are done reading that story, you are going to answer a constructive response. Okay? A constructive response is not just answering a question from a story, but it's constructing it with organization, using lots of citations or text evidence, and explaining yourself. So that's what makes a constructive response different from just answering a multiple choice question from a text. I want you to use race. We've done this before in class. So I got some of it started for you. Okay, so R stands for restate the question. A stands for make sure you answer the question. C means you have to cite evidence from the text. You're going to be using yesterday's text called Germs Are Not for Sharing, and you're going to be using today's text in the Reading Rainbow link called Germs Make Me Sick. Okay, so use both texts and see if you can cite evidence from both. And then E is explaining the text evidence by using words like because or so. Okay, so the question I want you to respond to is this one. What causes germs to spread, and how can you stay healthy? Okay, so I did some of the parts for you. I restated the question. So I said many things cause germs to spread, and there are things to do to stay healthy. Okay, so that was me restating the question. I put a period because the first sentence is just restating the question in your own words. Okay, for the second part, which is answer the question, you're going to answer what you just said. So you're going to say things like, one way to cause germs to spread is by, and then you go ahead and write your answer. One way to stay healthy is to wash your hands, or use a tissue when you sneeze. And there's all different examples you can use. Okay. And then the second part is to cite text evidence. So you're going to do that by starting off a sentence like this. The text said, and this is where you can pull words from the text. So you might have to go back to the story and find a sentence and write down a sentence that came from the book. Okay. If you want to try explaining today, that would be great. You explain one of the text evidence by using the words because, or so, and things like that. Okay. You have another assignment, which is to read the story, The Wolf in Sheep's Clothing. And this is a very different version of The Boy Who Cried Wolf and The Shepherd Boy. Okay, so it's the story is on page 23 and 24, and then your job is to answer the questions on page 25 today, and also answer the questions on page 26, okay? So you have to sequence the events and answer these. Okay. Okay, your math assignment today is, do you see that? On page 11. You're going to be adding today and you're going to be using different strategies like the decompose strategy. We know that one because we've done this a lot in class. Okay, so if you remember, decompose means to break down larger numbers into smaller parts. One way to break down a two-digit number that makes a lot of sense is to break it into tens and ones. Okay, so that's what I did for you. I took this problem from question number one and two because they're partner questions. The question was the math equation was 37 plus 53. So you can see how I decomposed 37. I decomposed it into tens and then ones, and I did the same thing for 53, okay? And then what now it becomes easier to add because I have tens right here. If I know 3 plus 5 is 8, then I can figure out what 30 plus 80 is, 30 plus 50, which is 80, excuse me. And then I'm gonna add the ones now. 7 and 3 is a make 10. So I have 80 here and I have 10 here, and that equals to 90. All right, boys and girls, I hope you have a great, fun day doing your assignments. Remember to post them on Class Dojo. If you did not get a chance yet, I really want you to read this story with me. I read it aloud to you, and so it's two movies that I posted to our class website. So on Class Stories, I can't post too many videos. It only allows me to post one, and so sometimes you're going to have to find things that I post on our class website instead. So I'll be using both, and if you ever need to get to our class website, I'll link it in the Class Stories. All right, have a wonderful day. Bye, see you guys tomorrow.